ट्रांसलेटिंग स्ट्रेटजी इनटू ऑपरेशनल इफेक्टिवनेस, दिस इज द वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ द प्रोडक्शन एंड ऑपरेशन मैनेजमेंट. प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल टॉक ऑन दिस इशू ऑफ द ट्रांसलेटिंग स्ट्रेटजी इनटू ऑपरेशनल इफेक्टिवनेस. फ्रॉम दिस द फर्म विल गेट इफेक्टिव, द एफिशिएंसी विल बी गेट इंक्रीज, प्रोडक्टिविटी विल बी गेट इंक्रीज. द प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार will talk on this issue. Operation management is likely linked directly and many initiatives that firms use to sustain and revitalize competition. These include such approaches as rapid product development, process improvement and total quality, lean production and supply chain management. As the workplace become more flexible, as information technology and e-commerce permit new and innovative work arrangement, and as customers become more demanding, operation management will continue to play a significant role from a strategic business perspective. Value is a core concept in business strategy because it directs organizations to strive to the understand and customer buying process. People part with their money to buy a product when it delivers from value, then the value then attribute to the money exchange. The value model assumes that a customer elects to purchase a product when a need exists and when the core augmented benefits derived from making a purchase exceed the product's cost. The ultimate driver for all activities done within the organization is to satisfy the targeted customer. The product should also offer more value than the competitor's product. This must be the primary way in which the organization views the marketplace and be a determinant of the strategy. The strategy tells the operations function who the targeted customers and what they want, estimate the size of the market and the anticipated distribution of the customers, profiles how the firm intends to compete to win these customers. The rapid changes in the competitive environment reflected by the clock speed are having a major impact on the strategy formulation and competitive environment. There are three forces that are the major drivers of these changes. Information technology provides vast new ways to communicate both within the operation, such as having machines talking to machines and between the players within the firm's supply chain, such as a B2B, business to business, vendor management software, B2B supply chain management tools that uses information technology to enhance the flow of the material within the supply chain are being adopted by the many organizers. Traditional purchasing may continue to exist, but the roles of the humans within the e-purchasing system will be dramatically different. This is the first choice. The second force is the market demand for the product customization. Customer can participate in leading edge firm's product innovation process. Example, Maruti Udyog Limited, the premier automobile manufacturer in India, has responded to the changing competitive condition in the market. In a bid to retain its premier position in the market, it is offering customization for its basic car model, the Maruti 800, even before the consumers have demanded it. This includes basic facelifting to a completely color-coordinated vision. The customer has been offered a choice of the color combination, material, and functionality advance. The facility is available on new purchase. It is also available for in-use car so that the company retains the goodwill of its existing customers. Customization has increased in importance as economies of sale no longer induce manufacturer to make standard products using the standard parts. Sundaram Fasteners Limited has split its earlier integrated manufacturing system into smaller production modules. The company calls these zones of the autonomous production. These have enhanced worker skills on the one hand and the company's flexibility on the other. The third major phase impacting operations manager is increased globalism, especially within the firm supply chain. This has been instrumental in creating a new production system of the worldwide sourcing, which is now a foundation of the new world economy. Instead of simply operating plants abroad, multinationals integrate those plants that manufacture their components as subdivision of a globally organized production process. General Motors sources its components from many as 50 countries. Its radiator caps are supplied by the Sundaram Fasteners. Globalism also impacts and the service sector. A small security setup in Hyderabad is providing security services for a number of the large integrated office complexes in the New York. Though it has placed no security personnel in the USA, another example is the emergence of India into a major player in software development. Infosys, NIT, HCL, etc. are primarily offering their services in offshore market. They service clients such as Ford, General Motors, GE, and Unilever, etc. Implementing the operation strategy involves the organizing, directing, implementing, and controlling the different facets of the management effectively. This process is difficult since it requires top management to secure and manage the resources needed to actually achieve the business strategic objective. Managers who can faithfully translate the thoughts of the top management and job workers who have the skill and motivation to deliver the results. At slow clock speed, the means used to deploy and implement a corporate strategy throughout a firm can be policy driven. As one moves down through an organization, each level down can define what its function need to support the firm's effort to achieve its strategic goal. First, you define the sub-goal, then install the business processes capable of achieving these goals. And lastly, you measure how well each business process contribute to achieving the business unit's objective. But at the high clock speeds, a top-down approach to the strategy implementation often fails because it cannot respond quickly to unforeseen opportunity and threats. In such cases, the organization's design must provide the firm's units broad strategy guidelines and then empower the units do that which is necessary to contribute to achieving its goal. In the faster lane, people become more important than policy. The reality is true for each of the firm's functional area, but it is especially true for its operation management functions. Once the strategy is finalized, it has to be implemented through the functional area. The operation manager must translate the strategy by working out the details of how it can or should be executed. Implementing business strategy is often problematic. The firm's expectation provides the basis for evaluating the effectiveness of the management. Implementing strategy is normally considered through a system perspective that views management as a three-stage process. In business environment, where the change of the pace is not very fast, this approach of the strategy implementation work well. The three stages are described below: the organizational level, the process level, and the third is the job performer level. This reflects the competitive strategy of the organization. It uses the corporate strategy as an input, then converts it into the broad description of how senior management want the firm and it units to be turned. Outputs of this level include organizational objective. The objectives define how the firm intends to achieve and maintain its desired competitive advantage as well as how the firm intends to benefit from said advantage. How much sales, market share, and earnings are expected. Organizational goals also include qualitative objective involving things such as repeat sales, service levels, awards, prestige, etc. Organizational design, this defines the arrangement of the units to implement the strategy. It involves both physical entity such as plant and equipment, the organization structure, and how it expects to treat the reward its people for performance. Organizational management, the specific objectives for each group are translated into measures to evaluate their performance. Formulate a resource management plan and develop an understanding of how the groups will interact with each other. The process level. This is the level at which the units actually do work. From the organizational level, the strategy has to translate it for each individual process. Process include such activity as order entry, product innovation, and the actual making of the product. The process level can again be broken down to the specific job systems. Process objective, these are measurable objectives for each of the processes. Example, manufacturing might be expected to translate customer orders into the products within 6 working days of being communicated to them. Process objective can be multidimensional. A production process might be bulleted on the basis of the cost, product quality, and on-time delivery reliability. Process design, in order to achieve the process objective, it might be necessary to design or redesign process. The objective is to provide each person with a work situation that can be done effectively when given proper guidance and adequate resources. Process management. This involves translating process objective into the specific sub-objective for its subgroup and matrices to evaluate their performance. The idea is to make sure that the way in which the process is managed is able to achieve the process objective. The job performer level, each process is a collection of the jobs. The jobs that have been identified need to be performed effectively. In order to do so effectively, jobs are broken down into the activity. These are the basic units of the implementation. These need to be organized and directed so as to provide the control to the management process. The activity of the job broken down to include the following tasks. Job objectives. Here we establish objective for the people staffing the process. Example, in a restaurant, a waiter might be expected to serve 5 tables in an hour during the peak shift with the minimum customer complaints. Job design, manufacturer's task is to figure out what way is then to train employees to do each task in the right manner. However, employees need to feel responsible for the appropriateness of their jobs. Job design is successful if it is planned within the context of the organization culture. Job management. The manager must manage each employee in a way that enhances the likelihood of the task being performed effectively. Fast-paced businesses are not fast-paced in all areas. The trick is to identify those areas that are not fast and use the same system to implement a strategy. In faster-paced activity, it pays to do so much of the work using the best practices approach. Best practices work well on the repetitive problem. This allows the organization to focus its care and talent on the future opportunity and the non-securing problems. Self-assessment. Implementing a strategy is normally considered through a system perspective that views management as a process. The level is the level at which the units actually do the work. The firms provide the basis for evaluating the effectiveness of the management. Implementing the operational strategy involves the organizing, directing, implementing, and the different facets of the management effectively. The bicycle ride. TI cycles are promoted by the family of the Murugappa Theatres in September 1949. The company was a collaboration formed with Hercules Cycles and Motor Co. of UK to indigenously produce complete bicycles and bicycle parts and the substitute. Substitute import. The bikes and the TI cycle manufactured were elegant, well-built, and based on the British design. They had inculcated reputation or quality and durability. For almost 40 years, the name BSA and the Hercules were synonymous with value. The future looked bright. Generations of the kid learned how to ride on elegant BSA or Hercules bicycles. A good bike enters the life of a childlike good friend. And many of these kids grew up to be the parents who wanted their kids to ride these bikes. However, over the 1970s and 1980s, the market for bicycle was changing, but the TI cycle seemingly did not quite understand what was happening. In Ludhiana, Hero Cycles grew from its origin as a small producer of bicycle to the largest manufacturer of the bicycle. Right under the nose of the TI cycle, at the heart of the Hero Cycles, success lay a different value creating logic. Hero Cycles developed their cycles to meet a specific Indian needs. They designed a cycle that could carry 2 people plus a heavy load at the cheapest price. They were not elegant products like BSA or Hercules, but they were designed for farmers to carry heavy loads of vegetables to the village market. In 1944, four Munjal brothers, headed by the Sri Brij Mohan Lal Munjal, came to the Amritsar from a small town called Kamila, now in the Pakistan. They decided to start a business of the bicycle spare parts in Amritsar. This business evolved into Hero Cycles. The Munjal family created a local component infrastructure by introducing friends and family members to set up ancillary units. They developed a policy of supporting these units with both funds and technical assistance. Much before just in time, production became popular. They adopted the system, leading to extremely low cost that allowed them to cut TI cycles price by the 15 to 20% even on the cheapest model. Over the years, it became achieved in both standard, especially bike segment. In 1989, a launched Hero Ranger to the satisfy the need that TI had overlooked cycles for the paddling on the rugged terrain. It created a new category of the mountain terrain bikes. Hero had further built as a market position by introducing fitness bikes under brand name Hero Algero. Our executive at the TI Cycles remarked, since our company had started the industry in India, the general psychology inside TI was that leadership position would continue owing to the technical sophistication of the product. Hero Cycles inevitably learned to make the cycles on its own and offered value for the money. It competed on price and tapped the price conscious segment. TI Cycles had failed its failure illustrates two facets of the business environment. The first is the phenomena called customer disconnect. This company had fallen to the display in love with that it had been, that it no longer insisted to what its customer and the bicycle market wanted. TI Cycle greatest failure was that it no longer understood its customers' value. Secondly, TI Cycle failed to see the disruptive forces that were changing its industry. The value of its customer were changing. TI Cycle could not fathom the changing value. New bicycle firms were assembling a wide range of the product, often using highly engineered components made by the others. TI Cycles took pride that it made all of its components. It could not see the merits of the buying components from outside supplier, but the new breed of the cyclists started to buy lower cost bikes through the same marketing channel that heretofore have sold the TI Cycle. In 94-95, the family dominated board of the directors had to wake up to the problem. The total loss from the operation of the TI Cycle was the 290 crores on a sale of the 208.28 crores. It had slipped to the number of three position in the industry, its sales in the domestic market, and the flattened out. The management had to admit that they need to be totally rethink their concept of the market, customers, competitors. They had to change their supply chain philosophy and follow a different path. This led to the initiation of a series of measures at TI Cycles in the product development and manufacturing. In early 1995, TI Cycle introduced the first bike with front shock absorbers. And in 95, Rock Shock FST with the front rear shock absorbers. In 1998, it created a category of the geared bikes under the Hercules Top Gear brand. In the area of the manufacturing, the company took a step at the shop floor manufacturing and sourcing. As a part of the initiative, TQM was introduced in TI Cycles in January 1998. A series of the small group of the activity and cross-functional teams were introduced in the company. The company obtained the ISO 9000 certificate in March 2000. It responds to these measures. Productivity per man per day increased from 2.5 cycles in 1994 to the 5.78 in 1992. In 1998, TI Cycle proposed to the A1 Cycles, one of the smaller players in the Ludhiana, that they would provide help in assembling the bike and ensuring quality and the market it under the TI Cycle brand. This proposal enabled A1 to utilize its capacity and the TI Cycle to open a standard cycle at a lower cost. With a view to further improve its cost, competitiveness and delivery, TI Cycles started a unit in Nasik, Maharashtra in 2000 to paint the assembly bicycle and cutter to the needs of the western and northern market. Thus has begun an attempt by one of the great company to make a comeback. Especially an organization must address two questions: who are we and what do we want to be? This is the mission of the organization and it defines its reason for existence. It might include a definition of the product and services. It provides technology used to provide these products and services, type of the market, important customer needs, and distinguishing competitiveness, the expertise that sets the firm apart from the others. The mission guides the development of a strategy by different group within the firm. It determines the value creation logic of the organization. Set limits on the available strategic option. It governs the trade-off among the various performance measures and between the short and long-term goal. It establishes the context within which daily operating decisions are made. It inspires employees to focus their efforts toward the overall purpose of the organization. TI Cycles provided value to its customers by producing elegant, luge quality cycles. To implement this strategy of producing high quality, beautifully designed cycles, TI Cycles adopted a policy of the vertical integration. It produced most of the components in-house, all the way down to the steel tubes required for the bicycle frame. It created organizational value and people process that supported the vision of the organization. Hero Cycles, on the other hand, a fundamental different value creation logic. It manufactured heavy duty, low cost cycle. Hero Cycles outsourced most of the component. It focused on creating a high efficient assembly operation in-house. Both organizations were good at what they are trying to provide. Where the DTI Cycles go wrong? On one executive at the TI Cycle analyzed the situation as follows. We have continued to maintain our position in our market segment. Hero Cycle tapped the price consumption segment, which turned out to be the largest market segment in the industry and is the leader in that segment. We did not see that market segment becoming so big, nor did we believe that we could compete on price with Hero Cycles. A clear understanding of the implication of the strategic choice on operational capability is vital to success. Without the capability to produce low-cost products, no amount of dreaming would have made Hero Cycles capable to provide a product to replace the BSA and Hercules cycle. Their ability to design bicycles that meet India's specific needs at the low cost made it possible for them to provide the right product at the right time and make them market leaders. TI Cycles' operational strategy of the producing elegant, high-quality bicycles become the corporate strategy of the company. This resulted in its inability to compete with the Hero Cycles. It did not develop the capability to compete on price, and hence it could not provide value when there was a shift in the needs of the market. How did TI Cycle lose its way? Analyze the bicycle market in India. The objective of the operation strategy should be to give the firm a competitive advantage. Performance depends on the functionality, quality, speed, timeliness, and flexibility of the product offering. The business strategy are basically competitive strategy whose objective are about how to compete successfully in the particular market. A firm purchasing a cost leadership strategy attempt to gain a competitive advantage primarily by reducing its economic cost below that of the competitors. In a differentiation strategy, a firm seeks to be unique in its industry along some dimensions that are widely valued by the buyers. The generic strategy of the focus rests on the choice of the narrow competitive scope within an industry. Richardson, Taylor, and Gordon have developed a six-element framework for operational strategy. Their framework elements are the technology, frontier mission, technology exploiters, technology servicemen, customizers, and cost minimizers. Implementing the operation strategy involves the organizing, directing, and implementing and controlling the different facets of the management effectively. Value is a core concept in a business strategy because it directs organization to strive to understand and customer buying process. Implementing strategy is normally considered through a system of perspective that views management as a three-stage process, which are at organizational level, process level, and job performer level. Keywords: corporate level strategy that are concerned with the broad and long-term questions of the what business and organization is in or wants to be in, and what it wants to do with some business. Flexibility: it is the ability of the operation management system to give the customer the product desired. Functionality: it is a measure of the extent of the product when properly used, is able to accomplish not the intended use. Generic competitive strategy that can be used by the organization to outperform competition and define its position in the industry. Quality: it is broadly defined as the extent to which a good or service is delivered consistent with that of the customer has been led to the expect. Speed: it is a measure of how long a customer must wait for the product once it is requested and how long it takes to design, develop, and introduce new products. These are the review questions. Explain the important issue associated with the key decision area in the operation management. What are the some of the current challenges that operation manager face in each decision area? To what extent will the sustainability of the competitive advantage depend upon the organization strategic capability or its position within the industry? What are the three generic strategy with which operation strategy must be consistent? The scope of the operation management encompasses value creation and support processes is the best explained by the types of the decision that operation managers face. Explain. As a developed nation become more industrialized, people gain in skills and influence. Many people are enter the labor force and very often both the spouses are working. How do these changes reflect on the role of the operation management? Explain. How do the three generic strategy differ and provide competitive advantage? Some way that Porter's generic strategy reflect the concerns of the operation management better than the framework of developed by the Richardson, Taylor, and Gordon. Do you agree? Give reasons for the position you take. From the point of the view of the operation manager, what would do in the changing market condition, what you adapt your operation capability or find new markets to fit your existing capability? Explain. It is important to understand the complex trade-offs involved in the operation decision as well as how the different decision area may be affected by such decisions. Give reasons to support your answers. These are the further readings.